गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू गुड समैरिटन स्कूल ईसापुर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। दिस इज़ योर सोशल स्टडीज क्लास एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी चैप्टर 6 इन हिस्ट्री, न्यू क्वेश्चंस एंड आंसर्स। सो फार वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट बुद्धिज्म एंड उपनिषद्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट जैनिज्म, द संघा, मोनास्ट्रीज एंड द सिस्टम ऑफ आश्रमस। सो लेट्स बिगिन। Jainism. Mahavira was a Kshatriya prince of Lichavis. At the age of 30, he left home and went to live in a forest. For 12 years, he led a hard and lonely life, at the end of which he attained enlightenment. So, enlightenment is said to be a stage where person is supposed to get God. He taught a simple doctrine. He taught simple thoughts like men and women who wished to know the truth had to leave their homes. So once they leave their home and go to these enlightened people, then they could also get to know the truth. This was believed. They had to strictly follow the rules of Ahimsa, which means not hurting or killing living beings. So absolutely they could not kill anything, any living being. Mahavira taught in the language of the people, which was another form of Prakrit called Magadhi. So they used to teach in the local language. The followers of Mahavira were called Jainas. They had to lead very simple lives and had to beg for food. They had to be absolutely honest and were especially asked not to steal. Men had to give up everything, including their clothes. It is very difficult to follow these strict rules. Nevertheless, 1,000 left their homes to learn and teach this new way of life. Many remained behind and supported those who became monks and nuns, providing them with food. So, this is all about Jainism. The next one is the Sangha. Mahavira and Buddha felt that only those who left their homes could gain true knowledge. They arranged for homes to stay together in the Sangha. The rules made for the Buddhist Sangha were written down in a book called the Vinaya Pitaka. So they could read all the rules in the book. Men and women who joined the Sangha led simple lives. They meditated for most of the time and went to cities and villages to beg for food. They were known as bhikkhus or bhikkhunis. This word comes from bhikshuk or bhiksha, which means to beg. They taught others and helped one another. So, as you can see in this picture, everyone is gathered around this person to get to know the truth. Next is monasteries. Both Jain and Buddhist monks went from place to place throughout the year teaching people. During rainy seasons, they used to stay together as it was difficult to travel at that time. Then their supporters built temporary shelters for them. As the time passed away, the supporters of monks and nuns, they felt the need for permanent shelters, and so monasteries were built. So monasteries as this one are the permanent shelters for the Jains and Buddhist monks. They were known as viharas, where a person could stay. Vihar means stay. Viharas were made of wood and then of brick. Very often, the land on which the viharas was built was donated by a rich merchant or a landowner or the king. The local people came with gifts of food, clothing, and medicines for the monks and nuns. The next one is the system of ashramas. So there are 4 different ashramas. Brahmins developed the system of ashramas. Ashramas means stages of life. So the entire life period of a person is divided into four different parts. Four stages of ashramas were recognized as Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha and Samyasa. So we will study these four in detail now. Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, men were expected to lead simple lives and study the Vedas during the early years of their lives. This stage is known as the Brahmacharya, this one, where they had to study the Vedas. Then they had to marry and live as householders, so the next stage is Grihastha. Then they had to live in the forest and meditate, which is Vanaprastha, this stage. This comes after the age of 50. Finally, they had to give up everything and become sannyasis, which is also known as sannyasi. So they used to leave everything and go to forest to meditate. Women were not allowed to study the Vedas and had to follow the ashrama chosen by their husbands. So these were the four systems of ashramas. So, for your homework, you have to do these three questions. To which tribe did Mahavira belong? Name the famous woman Upanishadic thinker. Paste pictures of famous thinkers in your notebook. I hope you understood this. Do this homework in your notebook and we will meet again in the next class.